So are you sci-fi people? Is this what you'd watch if you weren't in it?
I would definitely watch the show.
Yeah, now that I know the show, I would. Yeah, but okay. I don't think I was a sci-fi person. I've seen sci-fi before, mm-hmm. but no, I wasn't a sci-fi guy.
You're not a sci-fi geek?
No, okay. But I grew up collecting comics. I'm really into X-Men. Mm-hmm. I was really into like Wolverine, Colossus. Those were like my guys.
So for this then, getting that first script wasn't about the genre, it was more about the character development and what you could see. Has the first script to where you are now done what you thought it would do?
Way more.
Okay.
I ate on the call sheet. You know, I was the last series regular to get cast, and I didn't think my character would be developed the way it's been developed, and I'm very lucky and blessed that Adele and Meredith wrote that stuff for me. And I've had a blast, you know, playing Drake. It's been the funnest character I've ever played.
So, really?
Yeah, I really like this character a lot. Yeah.
What is it that you like so much about
him? I just think
him?
It's like he's got a lot of different layers. And he's, you know, one scene he's crying to his mom, and the next scene he's beating up four guys, you know, and falling in love with her. And as an actor, it's like, it's bipolar almost. It's like he's just got all these different sides, and they're all fun to play.
Are you as into your character as he is?
I do love my character. It definitely was the same thing in the beginning. The writers really have created this amazing character with lots of layers. But in the beginning, I thought she was just sort of the basic queen bee. And like, mm-hmm. I thought Drake was like the angry alien.
And I think that's what it was. And then we kind of, whatever.
You know, they see our work and, you know, they watch the dailies. And I think they explore our characters more. And I think that... I do love playing Taylor too. I think that where she's gone is two really interesting places. I don't think she's one note. She's a lot of depth to her, and so it's why we are actors, you know, not just to play the one note.
Mm-hmm.
One
exactly.
We have a lot going on, and our show has a lot going on. It's very political, and it's sci-fi, and it has everything in it. So mm-hmm. I think that's a cool thing about it.
Yeah, it's not a typical high school. You know, drama really isn't. There's so many. Like, the sci-fi world is really cool. And now that you ask that question, now I kind of am into sci-fi because I've gotten to know this whole world that they created. Mm-hmm. It's really interesting.
Did they tell you what's going to happen next season at all? I mean, did they give you a heads up of where your characters could possibly go?
No.
Really?
We haven't decided.
They don't tell us, and like we don't really know anything. We don't even know what the next script is going to be.
Wow.
Which is great because in life you don't know what the next day holds. So it's great as actors. Some shows they do tell you in advance what you're going to be doing to be aware of. I think they do that with certain people, but like, we don't know. And second season we don't know what things
yeah.
have.
So what's
again, making up.
Yeah. What's the tattoo process like for you?
For me, it's a long process because they got to cover my real tattoos. I have a bunch of real tattoos that they cover.
Oh, wow.
And then they put the fake ones on.
I have to say, though, now boys know what women have to do when we sit in those chairs. But
it's funny.
We did about an hour. We did like an hour.
It's over an
hour.
Yeah. I take longer in the makeup trailer than anybody on the show. It's kind of funny. And I have no hair.
Are you patient? Do you sit there and are you good?
Katie Frey is cool. We've gotten, our makeup artist is really cool. We've gotten tight. We know each other's life stories now because we spent so much time together. So, yeah, it's true.
So we hear the finale is epic. What can you tell us about it? I know you can't do any spoilers, but...
Yeah. I've been saying this. The last scene of the last episode is one of the coolest scenes I've ever seen.
I just got chills.
I mean, the music...
Whoa.
The scene itself, everything tied together, it's pretty cool.
You know, that's setting the bar really high when you tell us that kind of stuff, that you get chills.
You'll see it.
So much happens, and, like, and then the last shot, you're just like...
it's awesome. Yeah. I had to do ADR. I saw it before everybody, because I had to do ADR for it, like, a month ago. And the dudes were like, hey, we'll let you see it. And I was like, yeah, I want to see it. Let's do it. And I couldn't believe it. I called Meredith and I was like, have you seen it? She's like, yeah. I'm like, oh, yeah, of course I've seen it. But it's cool. Yeah, I'm proud to be in it.
Like, I'm just very excited by the show. I remember he saw the pilot episode and he called me and I was like in the plan and he was like, yo, nah. The pilot episode's so good.
I like it.
So you are a big sci-fi fan.
Yeah. I've done jobs where I wasn't into it, you know, and it's way more fun when you just like, you like what you're doing.
Is
like any job.
Can you imagine playing him for another 5 years, maybe?
I'd like to.
Really?
I mean, Drake can go a lot of places in 5 years.
Yeah. Space.
Yeah. On another planet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Could rule the world by then. Who knows?
Yeah.
He needs a good woman by his side. Yeah. You know, every great man is
a great woman. Let's hope Taylor can be a great woman. She'll make a space guy.
You look hot in a space.
How's the fan response been? Have they reached out to you? Like, how is it?
Yeah, I mean, on Twitter, they reach out a lot. We just talk about the videos that the fans made for Drake. They're a lot of fun, and they're so supportive. We love our fans, and they're so sweet, like, so beyond sweet.
Yeah, those videos they make are amazing. Yeah.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good day.